HY-TEK Bio is a small tech startup out of Maryland. And we have a combination of intellectual properties that allows us to basically reduce greenhouse gas emissions and pollutions from the burning of fossil fuels, coal, natural gas, whatever, methane. And we do that through a post-combustion process. So we don't touch any of the manufacturer's facility. We just tag on our technology to the end of their facility, grab their flue gas, and let the algae, which is what we use, mitigate that and consume all of the greenhouse gas emissions.
So my laboratory studies symbiosis. We're interested in the symbiotic relationship between bacteria and marine invertebrates, and also in symbiosis between bacteria and microalgae. We do a wide range of microbial work at IMET. So something we really pride ourselves on at IMET is that we are highly collaborative. We collaborate extensively within the university system, nationally and internationally.
I first met Mr. Robert Mroz, the president and CEO of HY-TEK Bio, about 6 years ago. At that time, they have a very strong team in engineering and marketing, but they don't have someone that knows how to grow algae.
HY-TEK Bio sees the power of algae in two different ways. One is its ability, obviously, to eliminate the greenhouse gases and the pollution from the burning of fossil fuels. The second is its value as a product in the marketplace to be able to produce other products.
My lab studies microalgae. We aim to understand how algae synthesize and accumulate lipids and byproducts. The particular strain we studied with HY-TEK Bio is HTB1, which produces lipids for biofuels and carotenoids such as lutein and zeaxanthin.
Everyone thinks it's easy to grow algae. It's not. You grow it in your pool, but it's not the same thing. You do it on an industrial scale.
In my lab, we isolate microbes from different environments. This includes viruses, bacteria, and microalgae. For example, we have several hundred strains of microalgae in the laboratory, and this collection of microalgae is extremely valuable for strain selection. The strain we use is called Synodismus obliquit HTB1. HTB1 stands for HY-TEK Bio 1. This particular strain was selected from several hundreds of microalgae strains that we maintain in the laboratories. And it can grow in high concentration of CO2, we're talking about 20% CO2. And it also produces high lipid content under stress environments.
The HY-TEK Bio sees pollution, flue gas, as a valuable product. We can take that, feed it to our algae, produce valuable algae, eliminate all of the greenhouse gases, and make a revenue stream from that. Algae needs three things to grow. It needs CO2, it needs light, and it needs nutrient. We have plenty of CO2 from the flue gas. We have plenty of light and cheap, but nutrients expensive when we need a lot of it. So how do you solve that problem? Well, we've developed a process that takes fresh chicken manure and converts it to a clear, odorless liquid full of nitrogen and phosphorus very, very inexpensively. We started like every other company in biofuel. But when I found out it took 2 tons of CO2 to make 1 ton of algae, the mission changed. The core mission then became mitigation of greenhouse gas. We just tack our technology on, and it allows us to remove all of the greenhouse gas, the pollution, have no emissions, no pollution, no greenhouse gas, no carbon footprint.